Our horizontal collection trenches are similar, just sideways. So rather than having these vertical wells in the top of the landfill, they'll kind of come out the side of the landfill, but the design is similar. We've got this wellbore filled with granular fill. It's also perforated. It would be sealed at this edge as well. I didn't show the detail, but again, we don't want a short circuit coming from the landfill out in the atmosphere. Again, there'd be a wellhead to adjust the flow, and then a flex connection between the wellhead and the lateral or header is connecting into. Where the vertical extraction well kind of, it's going to stick up out over the landfill over time as the land settles. We have a separate way of dealing with settlement inside the horizontal collection trench. So we've got this horizontal piece, and based on the way the waste settles, it's going to put different stresses on the pipe. So we want to give it some flex, and that's accomplished with a slip joint, which is just a larger diameter pipe over two sections, and that lets the pipes kind of move in and out, as well as pivot up and down a little bit, and keeps it from breaking. So maintains that open space that connects the vacuum and the header throughout the waste mound, no matter what happens. And similar to sloping the header, you would slope the trench as well so that it would maintain a positive slope while the waste was settling, and you'd give it a little bit of a steeper slope. So even if the waste settled in an adverse way, then you'd still be able to slope the water the way you wanted it to. And the way you slope it, there's some debate in design circles. Some people like to slope it towards the header and use it as a way to get more water out of the landfill. Some people like to slope it into the landfill to prevent the water from collecting in the header. Those are the wells and trenches themselves, but a landfill gas collection system consists of many wells and many trenches. So here are some general rules of thumb that you use to design your system, where you'd put your wells or trenches, and how to operate them. So for a system of vertical wells as well as horizontal wells, typically they're spaced 30 to 60 meters apart. So around each well or trench, you can imagine a radius of influence where the vacuum inside that well is going to propagate out through the waste, and that ends at about 30 to 60 meters depending on how much vacuum you're applying, as well as the compaction of the waste and other characteristics. For horizontal, you get 30 to 60 meters on the horizontal plane. Vertically, you tend to have less conductivity. So it's kind of like an oval. It's squished a little bit in the vertical plane. But when you plan the systems, you kind of lay it out so that you have these circles around each well or trench, and then they overlap with adjacent ones a little bit, just so that you have good coverage between everything. For both vertical and horizontal collection systems, you want a distance of about 5 meters between where your perforations start and the top of your waste. So in our vertical system, it's about 5 meters from here to here. Less than that, and you're more likely to start pulling in air. And then for the horizontal system, this one's shown with the final cover on, but the key advantage of the horizontal system is that it can be installed as the landfill is built up and lifts over time. You don't need to wait for the final cover to go on. So you'd want, you'd install this when your waste was around this level, and then you'd fill it for about 5 meters, and then that's when you'd open up the valve and when you'd be less likely to start pulling in air into the landfill. And we don't want to pull in air because it creates that explosive mixture. For the vacuum, typically the wells will have about 10 to 15 inches of water column in vacuum, and inches of water column is a kind of weird unit that's used really commonly in landfill gas collection system. 1 inch of water column is 249 pascals, or about 0.036 psi. So it's pretty low compared to some other systems, but it is enough to move landfill gas into the collection system. To accommodate for settlement, both vertical and horizontal systems use flex hoses between the wellhead and the lateral. Horizontal systems additionally will use slip joints along the length of the collection trench pipe in order to accommodate differential settlement along its length. Both vertical and horizontal systems use 100 to 200 millimeter pipes, generally around there, HDPE or PVC, inside a 300 to 900 millimeter borehole. And then in that annular space around that perforated pipe is filled with clean gravel as kind of a filter pack to prevent the well itself from clogging with the fines that are inside the landfill. So HDPE is a stronger material, but it's also floppy. When it gets hot, it kind of bends like a noodle. PVC is much more brittle, but that also makes it stiff and stick up well. So while the header and laterals are made of HDPE, the well itself might be made of PVC. And you'd be more likely to use PVC for a vertical well where there's not going to be as much stresses on it as a horizontal collection trench pipe, which is going to be really pushed around by the waste settling. So there you'd be more likely to use HDPE. For the timing of the installation of these systems, for the vertical, as we've talked about, you usually have to wait until your final cover is placed before you can go and drill in your wells, and that makes us miss out on the time of the landfill when it's producing the most gas, which is right when the waste is fresh. Horizontal, as I've been mentioning, we can add into the landfill as we're building it up over time. We don't have to wait till the final cover is in place. So it is head and shoulders above vertical in terms of maximizing the landfill gas collection. It just requires a little bit more planning and being careful with landfill operations to be able to install them and then not damage them while they're sitting there and you're landfilling around them. At the end, the vertical system will result in a landfill surface that has all these wellheads sticking up, and over time they'll stick higher and higher up, whereas a horizontal system, the top will actually be clear and the sides will be where you'll have these wellheads coming out. So if you want to do something like put a soccer field on top of your landfill later, you might want to do a horizontal system.